Hello everyone, my name is Bethany and this is my channel Bethany's Thoughts. Welcome back. Today I'm going to be discussing my January TBR. I've been planning my January TBR for a while now, and I've actually already started my January TBR, but I'm filming this January 5th. Like, we're well into January at this point. I really should get my act together. But now we're finally here. I'm going to be telling you what my January TBR is. So what I'm going to be doing is the Pop Culture Readathon that is hosted by Whitney and Lauren, which focuses this round on the 80s. This is their month-long readathon. The last full month-long round was in July, where they did the 90s, and now we're focusing on the 80s. I'm really excited. The boards for this are a lot of fun. The two boards that I'm focusing on is the Brat Pack and 9to5. I'll link all the information in the Twitter thread and everything all down below. I don't have a prompt for everything. I try to fill it as best I could. And there might see some of these that cross over. If you have any suggestions, or if any of these things double posts or suggestions for any of the prompts that I have missing, I'd have loved for you to tell me and comment down below and let me know. For the Brat Pack, we're starting off with the Pretty in Pink prompt, which is the pink cover. I plan to read The Swedish Prince by Carina Hale, or Hallie. This was an audio, actually. I started in December, so I'm just rolling it into January and just going to use it for the prompt because I feel like I've read a lot of pink covers and it seems to come up in a lot of different readathons I've been a part of. So I had no more pink covers left and I was like, I'm already reading this. Let's just use this one. Next one is Can't Buy Me Love for Fake Dating. Again, I feel like that prompt's been used a lot. I didn't really have anything that I could think of that was fake dating that I wanted to read. So sort of fits, but not really. It's Well Met by Jen DeLuca. That is a romance set in a Renaissance fair. So they're enemies to lovers. They really, really don't like each other. But at the Renaissance fair, in their characters, they pretend to flirt, which I feel like is close enough to fake dating, but not really. But I'm just going to roll with it. And it's been something I've been wanting to read for a while, so we're going with that one. I kind of went a little bit loose with these. Oh, I should mention, there is a really cool rule that Winnie and Lauren did this round. If you read a book that has some sort of disability representation, you get to mark off an extra square. I do think I have a couple of disability reps in my picks. And then for 9to5, it's Indigenous authors. I did not find any Indigenous authors that fit any of my picks, but if anyone has suggestions for that, I'd also be really open to it. And moving on, continuing. 16 Candles, A Number in the Title. I was having a hard time finding something that was in my TBR already existing that had a number in the title. But my Kindle saved the day from all my Kindle ebook sales that I do. And I found Top 10 by Katie Katunga. This is about, I've read some of it. I have not read all of it. And it is about two best friends in high school. They list off their top 10 moments together. They're best friends and they are friends to lovers. They end up starting a relationship. But what's kind of cool about it is it's their top 10 moments together, but they're all out of chronological order. You're getting their story slowly as you go, but it's not in chronological order. It's just as their top 10 favorite moments in their relationship / friendship. I really enjoy what I read so far, so I'm excited to get back to it and finish it. The next prompt is for the movie Say Anything, Opposites Attract. So for that one, I am reading Firelight by Kristen Callahan. That is part of my romance book club that I am a part of in my local area. This is what we do on Zoom together. From what I know from Firelight, it's like an arranged marriage. She is like this really vibrant woman and he is like, and I think he's disabled, like he's been injured or disfigured in some way. So he doesn't think that he's worth being with, but then they strike a really great passion and things happen. I don't really know a heck of a lot about it. I have it on my audio though, so I'm going to be listening to it. So I'm excited for it. The next one I have is for The Breakfast Club, which is your fave character trope. I had a hard time coming up with this. One of my favorite tropes is the Grumpy and Sunshine trope, which is usually the male character, but not always, is a grump and the woman is a sunshine type character, just really bright and vibrant, and the male is like brooding and grumpy and isn't very effusive. And them coming together is usually a great trope that I really enjoy. Great grump sunshine book that I found was By a Thread by Lucy Score. I've had that on my Kindle Unlimited now for the last few months, so I definitely want to get to it and read it. I've really liked Lucy Score's stuff before, so I'm excited to jump into that. The next one is for Ducky Dale. Who doesn't love Ducky from Pretty in Pink? And he should have been the one she ended up with, bottom line. It's Unrequited Love. For that one, I am reading When He Was Wicked by Julia Quinn. That is book 6 in the Bridgerton series. Teen Witch, that one is a teenage magic user. I'm going to be reading Legendborn by Tracy Dion. I'm really excited about that one. I've heard a lot of hype for that one. This is basically a King Arthur retelling, from what I understand. And there's magic, and the cover looks amazing. I've heard a lot of hype for it. I'm really, really excited about it. I have that one on audio coming through on Libby very, very soon. So, super excited. Then next I have Bright Cover, Dark Plot. That is the prompt inspired by The Heathers. Also not a movie I have watched, unfortunately. I decided for this one to do Shadow and Bone by Leigh Bardugo. I mean, I think the cover is sparkly. I don't know if it's super bright, but it is sparkly. I needed to fit this book on my TBR because I am participating in a buddy read on Discord for the Shadow and Bone trilogy. And I'm really hyped now because the show's been announced to be coming out in April. So I need to get a move on and read these books. So the first one I have in audio, I'm really excited for it. And the next prompt that I couldn't really find something that I wanted to read was Ferris Bueller's Day Off. That is a plot in or an author who lives in Chicago. So if anyone has any recommendations for that, I am open to it. And then moving on to my 9-to-5 board. So from 9-to-5, the first prompt is a best whorehouse in Texas, which is a steamy read. For that one, I have planned the rest of the Ice Planet Barbarian series. If you watch my wrap up, you know that I read the first one in the series, and now I'm like side-eyeing the rest of the series and want to read the rest of them. I have them on my Libby. I'm waiting for them. I don't know why. It's 6 hours. They're really short audiobooks, but they're not. I'm still waiting for them. So I'm hoping I'll get the next two in the series, crossing fingers, because my Libby app has the first 4 books. I read the first one. We'll see how it goes. But I'm really, really hoping that those come through in this month. Crossing fingers, because they're really ridiculous and a lot of fun. For the next one, Nobody Puts Baby in a Corner, the bad boy trope. For that one, I'm going to be reading Bottle Rocket by Erin McClellan. This was something that I had put on my TBR for Smutathon. I did not end up getting to it, and that was also, I used it also for the bad boy trope. A bad boy trope is not something that I usually like reading a lot of the time. I like more of my cinnamon roll heroes. I just decided I didn't want to find something new. I wanted to get something that I already had planned to read. So that's what I'm doing. It's on Kindle Unlimited. She does a great, Erin McClellan does some great smutty novellas that are tied into holidays. This one is tied into July 4th. So makes it kind of fun. And then for St. Elmo's Fire, New Adult, a new adult book. I don't think this book's technically new adult. I think it's young adult, but I will say I think it's older young adult, so I'm using it. That is The Reaper at the Gates by Safat Tahir, because the fourth book came out and I really need to read the fourth book, but I need to read the third one first. And I've been wanting to read this one now for a while, so I'm really, really excited. This is the one I'm going to get to this month. I'm hoping it's going to happen. We'll see how it goes. So yes, super excited for that. The next prompt is for Terminator, speculative fiction. I couldn't find anything for speculative fiction. I mean, I had a couple things that I was thinking about speculative fiction, but all of them I had to do was audios, and a lot of these books already on my list are audios. I couldn't find something that I at least had already owned, so I don't have a pick for that one. If you think of something, though, that's short that maybe I can fit into my TBR, let me know, and I will definitely look into it. Then we have the prompt for Witches of Eastwick, which is a polyamorous romance. And for that, I'm going to be reading another thing that I didn't get a chance to read in my Smutathon TBR, Gifting Me His Best Friend by Katie Robert. All the fire, all the time. It's one of her taboo romances, basically. There is a couple who are married the husband's best friend is going through something, and he decides to gift his friend his wife, because he's always low-key been, the wife's always actually been okay, low-key interested in this best friend, and all the menage a trois things happen. I love Katie Roberts' romances. They're so great. It's a smutty good time. I cannot wait. I'm super excited about this one. It's a holiday romance, but, you know, I don't know. The holidays can continue in January for me. I'm totally okay with it. So I'm really excited about that. The next one is Coming to America, Reading a Diaspora author. I also really couldn't find a prompt for that. I tried to look it up on Google just to see, like, options, and I just got really overwhelming of what diaspora means, and I couldn't really find my way through it. So our host gave some recommendations, but it wasn't anything I had readily available. So I don't know if anyone has recommendations or knows maybe something on my list already that's a diaspora author. I would love to know. And then next, I'm going to be reading for the prompt Beaches, an emotionally charged read. I'm going to be reading Vanishing Half by Britt Bennett. That is going to be also on audio. And I'm also going to be reading it for my local book club that meets over Zoom safely. I'm really excited about that one. I've heard really good things about it. I've heard it's very emotionally intense, so I'm anticipating that. It's basically about two sisters who end up living very different lives and having very different struggles and challenges. And I think it's like there's a element of some, I think one of them's white passing and one of them's living black as a black person, and how their lives kind of differ from each other. And then they come back together for something. So yeah, I'm expecting it's going to be very, very emotional and intense, but it sounds really good. And then for Fame, that's the movie prompt, Fame, which is such a great movie, is a hard-hitting contemporary. And for that one, I'm going to be reading Dear Martin by Nick Stone. I started Dear Martin. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to finish it. It's definitely something that I can read and go through really, really quickly. I just need to find the time to, like, sit down for a couple hours and be able to get through it. Dear Martin is a young teenager named Justice who starts writing letters to Martin Luther King about his feelings and his struggles and what he's been going through. I'm really looking forward to it. I wish, like, I started it and the writing was really great, and from just a very brief bit that I started. So it's going to read really quickly. I'm looking forward to finishing. And last but certainly not least, for the splash prompt, which is obviously that prompt is going to be from Mermaids. I have A Song Below Water by Bethany C. Morrow. This is something that I've had on my TBR before. I've wanted to read. Also really short, so I think I can get through it. It's just sitting down, man, and actually reading undisturbed in my life. This is basically, there's mermaids and there's a situation that goes down and there's a trial of some sort and there's voices being silenced. I've heard really, really good things about it. The cover is absolutely gorgeous. I can't wait to get into it and read it and finish it. So yes, this is my January TBR, kind of ambitious. So this is 15 books. I've at the most have done 16. I'm hoping I'll be able to do all of them because I really do want to read all of them. A lot of them are audios, only 3 physical and about 4 ebooks. All the rest are audios. So I'm hoping that'll make them go faster. We'll find out. Crossing fingers. I'm very excited about this TBR. So we will see. So that's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. Comment down below if you've read any of these, or please also comment down below if you have any recommendations or the things that I don't have prompts for. I would really, really appreciate it. If you like what you saw and want to see more bookish things from me, please subscribe and hit likes and bells so you can see my videos pop up in your feed. I would really, really appreciate it. If you want to follow me on all the things, all my social medias are linked down below and you can see those as well. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again soon. Bye!